akşamlar. Stanley, Türkçe'de gelen arkadaşlarımız biraz tanıma olanağı bulmuşlardı. Belki gelmeyenler varsa kısaca şöyle biraz tanıdık. Stanley Green, Amerika'da asıllı bir fotoğrafçı ve Fransa'da yaşıyor. Ajan Kuru'ya bağlı olarak çalışıyor. Eugene Smith'in de asistanlığını yapmış kendisi ve son 4-5 fotoğraf sergisinde de 4 ödüllü fotoğraflarında ödül alan bir fotoğrafçı. Kendisi bizi kırmayıp Türkiye'ye İstanbul'a imza bir atölye çalışması yapmaya geldi. Ve yaklaşık pazartesiden bu yana atölye çalışması içerisindeyiz. Aslında pazar günü atölye gitmesi lazımdı ama kendisi çok değişik bir insan. Bugün, yarın ve uçağa kalkana kadar sürekli bizlerle deneyimlerini bizlere aktarıyor. Bizlerin işte fotoğraflar çektiriyor bize ve onun üzerine söyleşiler yapıyoruz. Şimdi bugün bir fotoğraf okuma üzerine bir etkinlik yapılacak. Ancak bu etkinliği isterseniz biraz daha bizler yönlendirelim. Birincisi dünya fotoğrafçılarından örnekler seçtik. Onların fotoğraflarını okuyacağız Stanley. Onun haricinde sizlerin de yani bu 3 seriden sonra sizlerin de getirdiğiniz fotoğraflarınız varsa bir vakit kalırsa sizler de fotoğraflarınızı gösterebilirsiniz. Ama söyleşiyi fotoğraf üzerine yoğunlaştırırsak çünkü kendisi bir savaş fotoğrafçısı o alanlarda da video deneyimlerimizi Türksel'de anlattı. Aynı sohbetlere gelmesin diye arkadaşlarımız Zoya teşekkür ederiz adı. Ben daha fazla uzatmayayım çünkü epey uzun sürecek söyleşim. İyi dinletiler.
Hello, good evening. You're all comfortable. We've been having this workshop.
Workshop. Üniversitede yapıyoruz.
For, I think, what? A week, 10 days or months?
Aşağı bir hafta.
And I've taken them on a bit of a journey.
Seyahat çıktım bu workshop'a.
Maybe more of a psychological journey where they can try to understand actually why they're taking photographs.
Daha çok psikolojik bir seyahat olup bu insanların çektiği fotoğrafları neden çektiğini anlamaya çalışıyorum.
Because I honestly believe photography is about psychology.
Ciddi olarak inanıyorum ki fotoğraf psikolojikte çok yakından ilişkin.
And it seems more and more this is being borne out by psychologists and psychiatrists who are starting to look at photographs as one would look at Rorschach in a psychiatric terms or psychology terms. They're looking at the photograph now and saying, ah, this is what's going on inside the person.
Psikologlar da bunu daha çok söylemeye başladılar. İnsanların fotoğraflarına bakarak
one of the things we've discussed in this workshop is besides the psychological aspects of photography, we talked about passion, obsession, commitment, what else? Pop quiz, what else?
Psikolojinin yanı sıra tutkudan, takıntılardan ve çok şeyden daha bahsettik. Ama başka ne konuşulursa dair soruyor. Workshop'a katılanlar gibi bunlar bir isimler. Nelerden konuştuk?
Memories, bravo, what else? Mom.
Music.
Quiz, what else? What?
Music.
Music, what
else?
What else? Devotion. Film.
Film.
Okay, the only thing that you won't see tonight is film. We'll have to accept it. Because of Isa, they have provided something quite unique.
İFSAK bize çok özel bir şey sundu.
They have provided with me the tools to actually make all my arguments because they have this wonderful collection of slides which covers time, life, imagery. And what's really good, even for my colleagues that were in the workshop, talking about and all those influences that I've been hammering with you about. You know, some of the tragedy is that you have an incredible library, but you're useless. probably excluding a few photographers, pretty much my mega major influences are going to be shown, and we'll have a conversation about it. But you know, basically, you should just sit back and look at them and try to see how their work might relate to your work. If you see something in their work that you could actually say, oh, well, yeah, I've taken pictures like that, I feel that, I understand that. Because one of the things that we kept hammering on was memory and the idea of the snapshot and the idea of the influences and the idea of how something enters your body and stays there like a little time bomb, and then one day it explodes and all of a sudden you have your image.
Belki iki tanesi, Ayşe hepsini göreceğiz. Siz de bu fotoğraflara bakarken neler bulabildiğinizi, kendinizden neler bulabildiğinizi bakmaya çalışın. Konuştuğumuz şeylerden bir tanesi de anı olur. Anı derken, anı fotoğrafı anlamında söylemiyor da, workshop'ta konuşurken, içgüdüsel olarak içinizde kalan bir takım şeyleri yansıttığının üzerine konuşmuştuk. Bunlardan bahsediyordu. Bunları da göreceğiz. Bazen diyor şeyler farkında olmadan birikir ve bir gün bir patlama yapacak.
Put it in musical terms, Miles Davis once said that he takes sounds and he puts them in like a milkshake. All the sounds, he takes these sounds and influences and puts them in a milkshake. Shakes it up, pours it out, and has a sound. It's the same thing.
Bunu müziksel anlamda anlatmaya çalışıyorum ama örneğin diyor Miles Davis, notaları bir araya getirir, sanki bir milkshake yapar gibi bunları bir araya koyar. Çalkalar ve arkasından bir şarkı çıkar, bir müzik çıkar.
Or Dexter Gordon once said that he has all these sounds coming at him, bombarding his body. Some of the sounds he takes into his body, the other ones he rejects. It's the same thing with visual information, visual imagery bombarding your eyes. Some of it you take in and keep in your head. And the next thing you know, you've built up a library, and before you know it, that library has meshed itself to become your vision, personal vision.
Birçok notalar ve müzik parçaları tarafından bombardıman edildiğini düşünüldü. Ve bunlar daha sonra bir ve bir patlama yaratıldı. Fotoğraf da bu anlamda aynı şekilde çalışan bir sistem. Hepimiz görsel anlamda bombardımana uğruyoruz ve bunlar bir gün birikecek ve bir sonuç çıkaracak.
And me, like, I guess there's a growing group of us who are actually starting to look to the fact that we're not just being influenced by photography, we're being influenced by painting, by sculpture, by MTV, all those Danish photographers, that rock and roll kind of imagery. It's, you know, we're allowing ourselves to be open to everything. So we're taking it off sports photography, in my photography, somebody said to me, how do you become a war photographer, combat photographer? So, photograph punk bands, you know, rock and roll. It gave me that sense of movement and motion.
Sadece görsel anlamda bombardıman edilmiyoruz. Resimlerden, spordan, her şeyden etkileniyoruz ve bir yere buluyoruz. Bana soruyorlar, sen bir savaş fotoğrafçısın. Nasıl oluyor da bütün bunları bir araya getiriyorsun dediklerinde, benim etkilendiğim şeyler farklıydı. Ben bir dönemler punk müzisyenlerini çekerdim. Rock gruplarıyla turnelere çıkardım. Bütün bu deneyimlerim gelişmişti.
So, I mean, the only thing I guess that is missing tonight to show you what my argument about music is, it's a million music. So you're just going to have to imagine. Just look at the imagery, try to see again if this fits or if you can relate to it. And I tell you, quite truthfully, the images that you'll see, no matter if they're contemporary or they're very old, all of them, one time or another, have influenced me and I've taken them into my body and I've poured them out into my life. Okay?
Bugün elimizde olmayan tek şey müzik olacak. O yüzden fotoğraflara bakarken sadece kulaklarımızda müziği duymaya çalışıyoruz fotoğraflara bakarken.
Wednesday, the question, you know, we're gonna have a break between the two different bodies of work. The first group, as I said, is Time Life, 1840 to 1860 or something. And then we'll see a group of contemporaries who are the, let us say, the worked in Bosnia, so the best of the best. You know, a lot of combat, or like we like to term, crisis photographers, came out of certain, let's say, wars. Vietnam period, Beirut, you have Bosnia, my particular grouping is more the Caucasus and Chechnya. So these guys, we all, you know, we all came out of something. And later on, we went on to do other things. But you will always find, in most conflict, you will find this kind of grouping. Bosnia is a really good example, which has these young, young photographers that went on to this thing with no clue what they were doing. And the imagery that you see today, coming out of Iraq, being made by new young photographers, were influenced by these guys.
Bugün iki grup halinde fotoğraflar göreceksiniz. Biri 1940'larda 60'lara kadar olan daha eskiler, ondan sonra da daha yeni dönem fotoğraflarına bakacağız. Yani arasında Çeçenistan var, Bosna var, Irak var. Fark edeceksiniz ki Bosna'dan fotoğrafçıların hepsi çok genç fotoğrafçılardı. Oradan çıkan fotoğrafların enerjisi, dolu genç fotoğrafçılar tarafından çıkmıştı. Irak'ı da öyle. Hep genç fotoğrafçılar savaş alanlarında kendilerini atmalarını bu imgeler çıkıyor.
And what I'm going to do with that grouping, because I recognize some of them, I don't recognize all of them. If you recognize that work, if you see a particular image and you know who took it, scream it out so the rest of us know.
Göreceğiniz fotoğraflardan bazılarını ben bilmiyorum. Eğer aralarında sizin bildiğiniz, kim tarafından çekildiğini bildiğiniz fotoğraflarınız varsa, fotoğraflar varsa lütfen en iyisi kalları söyleyin.
The last work is Eugene Smith, who is my mentor. We'll speak more about that because Eugene Smith really created me, you know, but not in the way you would think. I mean, it wasn't like Gene Smith said, this is how you take a picture, this is how you print. Gene taught me about life. He gave me life experiences. He taught me how to drink wine. He taught me how to speak. He taught me how to appreciate painting. He taught me how that poetry was wonderful. And the most important thing that Gene Smith gave me, he gave me the appreciation of music. How music affects everything in the world. And how you have to have music and you have to bring it into your body. And how your language, your body moves, how you photograph is musical. It's about music and dance. Gene Smith.
Son olarak da Eugene Smith'in fotoğraflarına bakacağız. Eugene Smith beni ben yapan insandır. Bana deneyim kazandırır ama deneyim derken sizin anladığınız anlamda değil. Eugene Smith bana hayatı öğretti. Nasıl şarap içileceğini, nasıl düşüneceğini öğretti.
Okay, so let's start and see how this goes. 1861 is Paris. Feels in the dark. And if anyone who has seen my book, or remember the presentation, later we can show you my book. You see this picture? Well, I have a picture of a bulletproof wall. So this particular image, I remember that it got into my mind and didn't realize until I took a picture of the bulletproof wall of where it came from. When you see the bullet wall, which maybe we can do a little bit. See that? You turn on the light. You turn the
light.
See it? You see that image? Well, you got it. See? It wasn't true. Next. I'll try to do this as quick as possible. This is Franz Liszt. It's also by Philip Tadar. And it's 1886. And you see the portrait? Okay, here's one of my favorite students. There you are. Well, here's your profile. Your obsession. Someone beat you to it.
Portrait.
So you see the nose? Yeah, just the same thing you're dealing with, okay? And your work. Moving along, next one. There it is. This is infamous. Juliet Margaret Cameron. Now, Juliet Margaret Cameron, I saw her picture. I was just amazed. You know that she used to take her subjects and like bolt them down into a chair and they would like sit down 15, 30 minutes while she messed around and took that picture. So that when I started doing fashion, I was a fashion photographer, I wanted to get that same effect, of course, with the new technology and faster film. But I also wanted to have the models. So a lot of my pictures were done with very slow shutter speeds. Because I really wanted to get the same kind of feeling that she had at first.
Okay. Juliet Margaret Cameron.
You can't catch it. You can't realize where my influence is coming, and you look at it, well, it's not. Maybe even a big influence on him, but he may not admit it. Probably he wouldn't admit it. But he's influenced, isn't he? Want to take a stab? Easy. Next image. Beautiful, huh? Gorgeous. Fashion. Did you see? I did this picture back after he came back from, right after he recuperated from the war. It was like, you know, we had the soldier carrying, coming back from the war. And you have, with the metaphor of the women that sew, you know, the bundle. So one day she went to the place where we hired her, who was working. We had a long discussion about it. I told you that she was at Image Works, and but I knew about Minor White and wanted the chance to go to Image Works. He really believed that to really appreciate a photograph, you have to stare at it for very long. It was crazy as everyone thought at the time that he was. It actually might have been honest. But if you skin. But even after we're told that it's a street light, you still can't shake off the thing that it's blood, and you still. Thinking in my, okay, one of those evil punk bands wearing boots. Put it in some kind of context where you can actually make them look good, even though you're sweating, they were most of the time they were ready to shoot you. Anyone know the pictures of Larry? It's like construction. It's like. Put it in a black and white comic. You know, the creepiness, the horror. You can make, you know, when the war is going on around them and whatever. You know, he did war. He did social issues, documentary. He was a non, you know, non-objective photographer.
No, they were going, they, we'd all moved out of the APLs. They were like moving away, but they
came upon the scenario to photograph it so people would know what's going on here. When they were doused with gasoline and burned, anyone that's photographed with a 6x6 format know me, okay? Because I want to get the righteous position. So when I fall down, I always go down on one knee.
Zaman harcadım üzerine diyor. Çünkü çerçeveyi yapmak zorunda olduğunuz için doğru noktada olmalısınız. Doğru noktayı buldum, dizimin üstüne çöktüm ve tam anlamıyla bir makara film çektim. Aşağı yukarı 10 tane de ve doğru açıyla. Arkasından onunla da yetinmeyip 35 mi en kötünün en kötüsü neydi? Ama sanki ellerde çekilmiş fotoğraflara benziyordu elindeki silahlarıyla. Bir bedel var ve bu bedel çok büyük olabilir ama bunu ödemek zorundasınız.
There is nothing romantic about being
ne kadar bu yoldan gidebilecek misiniz? Bu bedeli ödeyebilecek misiniz?